Hi, I'm Vincent Rajkumar from the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. I'm at the ASCO meeting here, and I want to just highlight like five of the top myeloma abstracts that were presented at this meeting. I would say the number one abstract, which generated a lot of excitement, was the update of the CAR-T trial using BB2121, which is a CAR-T against BCMA antigen. And they are showing very sustained responses. Most patients respond, most patients have MRD negative level of response. And the median progression-free survival is approximately 1 year. And that is very impressive because it's three times longer than what we had with drugs that are blockbusters like lenalidomide and bortezomib and daratumumab. The second abstract was a study that compared once weekly versus twice weekly carfilzomib. That's a randomized trial. Twice weekly is very inconvenient and is the current approved form of using that drug. But once weekly makes it very convenient for patients, and this trial shows once weekly is safe, effective, and so I think this will be of great help to patients. In that same line, there was also a study that looked at daratumumab given subcutaneous versus intravenous, and they showed that the subcutaneous formulation was well tolerated and effective, and so that's another thing that'll help patients in terms of quality of life. One other phase three trial was the pomalidomide bortezomib dex versus bortezomib dex trial, which showed that there is one other triplet that's quite active in relapsed multiple myeloma, that is pomalidomide bortezomib dex. And so that was one other abstract that came in. And finally, there is a trial that looked at carfilzomib at a low dose, the usual dose that we give of 27 milligrams per meter squared, versus a higher dose of 56 milligrams per meter squared. And this trial found that there was no significant benefit in terms of outcomes by using the higher dose of carfilzomib. So I think the lower dose stays the standard. So in summary, we have one abstract which is showing a very active new drug, which is the CAR-T BB2121. Three abstracts telling us how to use these drugs. That'll be the daratumumab subcutaneous route, carfilzomib once weekly, as well as the lower dose. And then we have the pomalidomide bortezomib dex as a new regimen to treat relapsed refractory disease.